Well, Brock, the fans were out and shouting J-E-T-S Jets well before the gates opened here. And now they fill the stands of MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Joined by a former NFL quarterback up in the booth, Mr. Brock Heward, I'm Kate Scott. And Brock, you can brag if you'd like to, because I know you had quite the big arm in your days with the Huskies and the Seahawks in Seattle. Well, we've got a couple of quarterbacks here who also know how to push that football down the field.
Yeah, you got a couple QBs who are going to keep these defenses honest today, because the moment they get greedy in coverage or get too aggressive in the pocket, either of these quarterbacks can drop a dime, drop a deep throw right over them for big yardage, and maybe 6 points too.
Here's Tyler Bass to get this one started. And away we go from East Rutherford. His return starts at the five. He's brought down at what looks like the 24-yard line. So the Jets take the field for their first drive. They're led out by the four-time MVP who's been in this league since 2005, Aaron Rodgers.
Well, these Jets fans, they've been waiting for this moment. They only got four snaps of Aaron Rodgers a season ago before, unfortunately, that Achilles snapped. He's put himself in tremendous shape. He worked to almost get back last season. And that arm and that release, Kate, it is still one of the most dynamic in the game.
All right, let's get this show on the road. It is first and 10. They'll start this one out with Hall. And he'll go down after pushing this up to the 29. Halfway there on first down, that brings up second and 5.
That run's not going to turn many heads, but at the end of the year, I promise you, if you average over 5 yards a run, you can be a Pro Bowler.
Halfway to the marker, it's second and 5. Here's Hall once more. And he's going to bring it up to the 40-yard line before he stopped. And that one goes for a gain of 11. And it's good enough for a New York first down.
You know, the elite running backs in this league, they don't just see what's right in front of them. You set up big runs like this because they see what's behind them. That's called extraordinary vision and extra yards.
Off the play fake, here's Rodgers. This is reeled in by Wilson. And he's brought down for a loss.
Well, if they were concerned about losing yards, running it on first down, it just happened anyway. Not many passes end in a loss. Hopefully they got a little more aggressive strategy coming here on second down.
All right, here we go, second down. So the officials are officially on board tonight. For the first time, a flag flies. Somebody moved early. One of the most common penalties in the sport, and the reaction, it's the same every time, Brock. Frustration from the coach as they get backed up 5 yards. Back to the line they go, it's second down. From the shotgun, Rodgers. Tight end reels in the shallow throw. And he'll go down, and we'll say right at the 39-yard line.
Quarterbacks will look for their tight end short in just about any situation. They take away the deeper options. Well, there's their consistent source of positive yardage, the trusty tight end.
Wonder what's in the playbook here as they come up on third and 11. Working out of the gun, it's Rodgers. He's on the move. Trying to get away from the pressure, but he can't, and they drop him. And the defense comes through to back him up ahead of fourth down.
All right, first sack on the board on the first drive as a defense, and now, well, now we let the chess match begin, the adjustments begin, because we know pressure leads to sacks, and sacks in this league often leads to wins.
So on fourth down, the Jets turn to a fan favorite. It's Thomas Morstead to punt it away. Pulled in at the 20, and they bring him down to put a stop to that return. So now the Bills will get their turn at an opening drive of the game. And leading them out is the seventh-year pro. Seems to be in the MVP conversation every year now. It's Josh Allen.
We've seen a lot of big arms come and go in the NFL. Few translate that talent, though, into stardom quite like Josh Allen. It's fun for me on the college football road when I ask these young quarterbacks who they idolize, who they look up to. And just about every big guy that can run says the same thing. Josh Allen, because that skill set is so tantalizing. A player who can rip off a highlight reel play with the pass, and just as easy with the down in just about any situation.
Shakir with the grab. And he'll get it up near the 38-yard line before going down. A nice gain of 13 yards as it brings up a first down.
That is what elite offenses are all about. Why worry about three downs when you need only one? Move the chains in one play and keep driving that defense backwards.
On first down, Allen finds a man on the right side. And he'll get it up to the 44.
He's just one of those guys, Kate. Even when he's not open, he's still a target thanks to that physicality and his ability to just play bully ball. They don't like forcing into coverage, but sometimes when you got a bully like him that can create space, you just find a way to get him the ball.
From the 44 here on second down. It was there, but he couldn't hang on. That's incomplete.
I think everybody in the building was already thinking about the next play to run as they watched that short throw to the tight end. That's a gimme. You don't expect to see many of those dropped.
Last pass unsuccessful, and they have third down here. To the air again, Allen. Complete beyond the marker. And he's tackled after getting this to the opposing 46. They get an even 10 on that play. And that's good for a Bills first down.
That's what we call situational football. You spend all week working on your nickel passing game package to take advantage of third downs just like that.
New set of downs for him from the 46. First tone of the game for James Cook. And he's able to take this up pretty close to that 40-yard line. First down play, nets him 5. It's going to be 2nd and 5.
The humble 5 to 6 yard gain on the ground. Not a huge gain, not a game-changing play by any means, but one that keeps you on schedule and takes some of the starch out of that front 7.
Another one for Cook. And he works this to the 38 before going down. Call it 4 yards, and they're set up with a manageable 3rd and 2.
That is just a good, solid run right there. I know, that's pretty basic commentary, but sometimes football can be basic. It keeps you on schedule. That kind of yards per carry, and you move the sticks.
Again, it's Cook. And he's brought down after a nice gain and a first down.
That right there, that will make the coaches happy. He didn't just get the first down, but got a healthy chunk of bonus yards afterwards.
Moving the ball very well out of the gate here. It's set up now at the 26. First down throw for Allen. Short pass caught by his tight end. They rip off a big chunk of field, and it sets him up with 1st and goal.
You want to become a quarterback's best friend, do that. Turn a short little gain, a short little pass, into some yards after catch, and that quarterback will find you again.
They'll break the huddle and come up on 1st and goal. From the red zone now. And that one's behind him. That's incomplete. Gonna have to wait a little longer for his first catch of the game. So now it'll be 2nd and goal.
Can't cover it much better than that really well-covered gate on that play. There just simply was not a window for him to sneak that throw in.
So the incompletion on first. Here's 2nd and goal. Allen looking to throw. An all-around tough play for him. He took a shot on the release, and it definitely affected the throw. It's incomplete.
That is a DB's best friend, pressure. That pressure earned that incompletion. They came in before he could find a target and hit him to alter that last-second attempt to get rid of it.
They've held him out twice. Here we go, 3rd and goal. Allen gonna throw again. And he will score! Touchdown, Buffalo! The Bills have a great first drive and get the game's first points. He finds one of his great receivers, Brock, and they are off to a great start to begin this ball game.
Yeah, it's such a positive offensively when you can go find not just a field goal, but a touchdown on that opening drive. And defensively, this starts to shake the foundation of your preparation and makes you wonder what's in store.
Tyler Bass on now for the extra point. That one right down the middle. And they add one on to their first touchdown of the contest. Bass now to kick this away. Xavier Gipson now to return. And pretty solid field position starting out here, Brock. He's tackled at the 29. The second drive coming up now for the Jets offense. And they're certainly hoping for some better results here after that first drive ended in a punt. They'll get this drive started. First and 10. They start the drive with Hall. And he'll take this up to about the 34 before he stopped. Give him 5 on that carry. Bring it up 2nd and 5.
You gain that kind of yardage in the run game, and you're going to gain the trust of your offensive coordinator. Plays like that, runs like that, set the table for everything else in the playbook.
Give on 2nd to Hall. And not much doing. He stopped quickly. 2 yards on the pickup, and that leaves him with 3rd down and 3.
You know, they got some positive yards. That's a good thing. But too many plays like that, it just is too hard to pile together, get first downs against the better defenses in this league.
Now Rodgers on 3rd and short. Got Williams, and it's complete. And he goes out close to that 45-yard line. That one ends up a gain of 6. And it'll give the Jets a 1st down.
You're not going to last long in the National Football League if you don't convert a good chunk of your 3rd downs. Nice find there to continue the series.
1st down, Rodgers. It's taken in by Williams. And he's got a decent gain before being brought down.
Well, that's a pretty similar result to a 1st down run play. Moves it forward, keeps you on schedule, and makes 2nd and 3rd down a whole lot easier to manage.
Halfway to the marker, it's 2nd and 5. Off play action, Rodgers. Throw complete to Williams. And they're going to bring him down at the 36. That's the end of our first quarter. 3 more to go still on Monday night. Neither side separating much so far. More from MetLife coming right up. Time for the 2nd quarter of play. It's Jets football. They're looking at yet another 1st and 10 on this drive. Catch is made down the right sideline. It's a great pickup, 16 yards, and now they've got 1st down.
Kate, when you watch the combine, you'll watch guys try to make this throw. And without chemistry, it's so hard to execute. That was picture perfect. That's a QB and receiver on the same page, because that route, that deep out to the field, that takes just a different level of connectedness.
Still on the move, coming to the line for 1st and 10. Throwing once again, Rodgers. Hits his man on the out route. And that tackle stops him after a solid gain. Following that completion, remember the O-line looks to be in some pain. They're headed out to take a look at him now. Halfway to the marker. It's second and five. Coming right is Hall. And he's tackled with the first down yardage.
Well, looky here. You don't even have to worry now about a third down call as that run moves the sticks. Now that call you had ready, though, you could recycle it. Save it for later for that next third down coming.
They'll keep this drive moving and come to the line for first and ten. Rodgers here from the gun. Escapes the pocket.
Well, this is in every quarterback's tool belt, even the ones not regarded as the best movers and shakers. But, Kate, to play QB in the league today, you've got to be able to do this. If you've got nobody open, still get some positive yards with your legs.
Second and six coming up here. To throw, Rodgers. And he will score. Touchdown, New York! The Jets start to fight back with their first points of this game. Malachi Courtley, the touchdown. Great opportunity to find a touchdown there, Brock, and they come through with six.
Receivers want the ball everywhere on the football field. But you start smelling the end zone, they really want their chance. And they will tell you as a quarterback, just give me an opportunity and I'll make a play. And he sure did.
Greg Zuerlein for the point after try. That one splits the uprights, and we're all knotted up. It's all lined up. Morstead, ready to send this flying. Fielded at the seven. He stopped on the return at the 27. The Bills, and they're wide out, headed to the field for a new series. And after the impressive drive we just witnessed, you gotta imagine that they are hoping to respond with something similar.
Yeah, and I don't love to use the word can't, right? But this can't be a three and out for this offense right here. They got to give their defense a chance to catch a breath and turn some of the momentum in the building.
They're out and set, first and ten. They send the tight end in motion. First and ten, here's Allen. And there's a man there, it's intercepted. Sauce Gardner with the INT.
You know, one of the beauties of the game of football is it never sits still. It's constantly adapting. And that nickel defense right there, critical in taking the ball away. And when you think about nickel defense, you think about Rondé Barber, won the Hall of Fame in the summer of 2023, really revolutionizing the position of the nickelback. That nickel defender and that nickel defense, critical in that takeaway we just saw.
The Jets and Aaron Rodgers headed back out on offense. And I'm pretty sure, Brock, they hadn't even all sat down on that sideline yet to rest. And now they're right back out there with a great chance to repeat their last touchdown.
And you will take that every day of the week and twice on Sundays. You don't mind at all. You got that defense right now reeling after the touchdown. And look at where they start with the football now.
New slate of downs to approach here from the 40. They'll go right side with Hall. And he's caught behind the line for a loss.
Well, he was supposed to be the one who chipped away a few and got a new set of downs started right in rhythm. Instead, he's now forced to pick himself from behind the line thanks to a great effort defensively.
Everyone's prepped. It's second down now. Now here's Rodgers. Quick hitter complete. And he works this to the 38 before going down.
Textbook hitch route. Just hit him in the short field and deliver it once that defense turns their attention elsewhere. Kate, this is a low ceiling play, but a reliable source of yardage.
Let's see what they draw up on these 3rd and 7. Rodgers to throw. And he rocks the tackler. And he's stopped at the 31-yard line.
All you can do is shake your head sometimes. Sure, the pass play works, but they come up just an inch or two short for the first down.
Only need the length of the football. It's 4th and inches. They'll run for it with Hall. And he's able to take this one down to the 25. They come through with 6 yards there, Brock, and they're rewarded with a new set of downs.
Come on now. Was there any doubt who they were going to go to right there? That was always going to be a run play. And no problem converting on 4th.
They have themselves another 1st and 10. Rodgers set to pass. And his perfect start is over. And that's the first one of his throws to wind up incomplete.
As a defense, you got to see the pass. You got to time up your hit, and you got to jar that ball loose. Not a lot of offensive players are hanging on to that one through a well-placed hit.
No dice on that prior pass. Here's 2nd down. Rodgers will look to throw. Conklin brings it in. And they have this down to the 11 before being marked down. Big gain, 14 on the play. And it's good enough for a New York 1st down.
I'm sure coach and play caller doesn't mind making the job a little bit easier. You know, play calling's a lot simpler and easier when you count on the offense to move the chains on those early downs.
He brings the offense up now for a 1st and 10. Working inside the red zone. He's got it! And that's good yardage there with a new set of downs to boot.
I love throwing on 1st down. And when you see a 1st down pass just like that, it's taking advantage of a matchup you planned for, and you go out and execute.
This offense in position now. It's 1st and goal. Again, Rodgers. And he will score. It's a New York touchdown. The Jets pick it off and get points on the ensuing drive. Malachi Corley the touchdown. His 2nd scoring catch of the game. Right on the edge of the goal line for 1st and goal. And I don't know about you, partner, but that surprised me that they just threw it in. No attempts at running it.
Yeah, I think it is so hard for these defenders. You got to be so keyed in and physically, you know you've got to stop that run first. So a 1st down pass play can and certainly was effective.
Zuerlein on now for the extra point. That one right down the middle. And they'll continue adding to their lead. It's all lined up. Morstead ready to send this flying. Here's a return from the 7. Coverage team gets him down at the 26-yard line. Well, we've already seen some nice plays here, and we're going to see plenty more before this game ends. But you might be thinking, with plays like that, my guy's ratings should be better. Well, you're not alone. You got a chance to let the Madden Ratings Hotline know just what you're thinking. Give them a call. 1-844-MADDEN-1. And make your case for who should get a boost. Offense ready to begin this drive, 1st and 10. Looking to throw here and shake off that previous INT. Finds his man en route complete.
That is the epitome of staying on schedule. That kind of completion right there on 1st down. Well, it opens up the entirety of the playbook for 2nd down. In the third and short in your back pocket, you can get even more aggressive and take that shot.
After a good pickup, they're set up with second and short. Throwing here, Allen. Got a man over the middle, complete. And he's going to bring it up to the 40-yard line before he stopped. Pick up a 5 on that play. And that's good for a Bills first down.
That's just great instincts. Go air it out on second down rather than just play conservative and run it. They hit a weak point in the coverage and don't need to worry about third down at all.
They're running the option, short side. And he drives it up past the 45. He managed 6 on the play, bringing up 2nd and 4.
The difference right there, Kate, between that gain and a big hit for a loss, some really quick decision making. He made a quick read, saw the running back was going to get hit if he handed it, and he pulls it himself for a positive gain.
They put a receiver in motion right. Operating from the gun, it's Allen. Complete to Coleman. And this is marked down right along that 40-yard line. It's a 13-yard play, and that's enough for the first.
Move the chains! Gotta move them chains! Build momentum and keep that defense on its heels.
New slate of downs to approach here from the 40. So it's the 2-minute warning here from MetLife. The Bills pushing for a score before the break. On first down, Allen. Complete to Shakir. And he gets down to the 24 before he stopped. He finds him 16 yards and a new set of downs.
Sure seems like he knew exactly what he wanted, and he got it going right where he wanted to with the ball off the snap.
They're now set for a 1st and 10. Working from the gun, it's Allen. Rifles it, and it's caught. And they get this down to the 12-yard line before being stopped. It's a gain of 12 there. And that's good for a Bills first down.
Good offenses. Okay, good play callers know how to utilize their personnel. They know where they wanted them. They wanted them on the route in space where he could make that initial play comfortably, but then go to work after.
From the red zone now. He brings it in. And he's short of the first after a mild gain. The Bills are going to go ahead and call their first timeout. They'll have 2 left to work with before halftime. Halfway to the marker, it's 2nd and 5. To the air again, Allen. And he will score. Touchdown, Buffalo! The Bills earn the chance to tie before halftime. All right, partner, what do you think? Was that a design read, or did he just see space and he was reacting more on the old quarterback instinct there?
Yes. I think yes on both of them, and that play happens so fast that it really is instincts on both sides.
Basson for the extra point. That one splits the uprights, and we're all tied up. Bass now to kick this away. Returning it from the 4. The return manages to get just beyond the 30. The Jets headed out on offense late in this first half. And with just under 40 seconds left to go, Brock, they can try a drive, but they gotta hurry. They've got first down from the 31. Working out of the gun, it's Rodgers. It's incomplete. Should have been a catch downfield, but off his hands and to the ground it goes. Looking for his wide receiver there. And now they face second down.
There's the importance of staying in phase as a defender. He was all over him in coverage, and that really did help force the incompletion.
On second and 10 now, Rodgers able to find Corley. And he's going to bring it up to the 40-yard line before he stopped. The Jets take their first time out. They'll have two left to work with before halftime. Third and a lone yard coming up. From the shotgun, Rodgers. Complete beyond the marker. Pickup of two here. And it'll give the Jets a first down.
You know, they call that the money down for a reason, because you're just simply not going to last long in the NFL if you don't convert a good portion of your third downs. It's the money down. And nice to see them roll the dice and continue the series.
Throwing once again, Rodgers. And he's just going to get rid of this one. Smart move there. When you saw the field, it's going to be second down. They'll throw again. Rodgers rifles it, and it's on the money on the slant. Timeout taken by New York. That's its second. And they still have one in their pocket for what's left of this half. So the Bills going with a dime package now on third down. Throwing again, it's Rodgers. And that's going to be incomplete. Still time for a couple of plays, though. 15 seconds left.
Well, that was almost one of those nice chunk plays you like to see in the NFL, Kate, before he was able to recover and provide the hit and ultimately dislodge the football. You like to see that physical edge and scrappiness to contest any kind of shot plays down the field.
Punter takes the field on fourth down, and he sends this one flying. Fair catch called for and brought in at the 11. We don't get a return out of that punt, and hardly any time remaining for them in this game. Only 10 seconds remaining here, so first and 10 may be our last snap of the half. All right, keeping it simple. They're just going to call a give right up the middle. And he's tackled after gaining a handful. Halfway there on first down. That brings up second and 5. We're at halftime here on Monday night. Now we'll send you down the East Coast to our studios in Orlando. Jonathan Coachman and the EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Kate, sit tight. We'll get back to you and Brock in just a moment. But for now, this is our Halftime Report.
All right, thank you, Coach, and we are back and about set to begin the second half. Well, we're set up for an incredible second half, all tied as we kick it away here in quarter number 3. That's going to be taken in at the 8. They'll bottle him up as he gets the return to the 30. Now here's the Bills' offense. They've got it first to begin the third. And they could take control of the second half early, Brock, if they break the tie on this opening drive. First and 10 now from the 30. From the shotgun, it's Allen. Short pass caught by his tight end. And he's got a decent gain before being brought down.
That's what you call efficiency. Exactly what you're looking for on first down. Textbook. It sets up second and very manageable, and then creates that space if you want to take a shot downfield.
After a good pickup, they've got second and 4. From the 36. Brought in by Hollins. And that's good yardage with a new set of downs.
Well, that is pretty darn impeccable timing between the two. They hit a curl route of that length. It takes great anticipation and precision by the quarterback, and the receiver on the other end finishing it, doing his job.
First and 10 from a yard shy of midfield. Shotgun handoff now to Cook. And they get there to take him down right around the 41.
Well, that doesn't net a first down. You get yards like that in the run game, you will take it in the NFL.
In a good spot here, second and inches. Motion man sent left. From the 41. Connection made to Shakir. And he gets down to the 24 before he stopped. It's a gain of 17 on that one. And that's good for a Bills first down.
Nice to see that connection, that chemistry working between the two of them.
The drive picks up here, first and 10. Allen. That'll be complete to Hollins. And he's going to be taken down near the 8-yard line. Give him about 16 yards on that gain, Brock, and it sets him up with first and goal.
They like to say it's about the Jimmies and the Joes. I think that's about the X's and the O's. That's a well-drawn-up completion that nets them a first down.
Four downs now to get in. Here's first and goal. Working inside the red zone. Cook calls it in, and he's brought down real close to that goal line at the 1.
Well, this is the type of game we've come to expect from him as a runner, toting the ball, but he's just as adept at turning the screen into the same kind of yardage, too.
Second chance at 6 here. It's second and goal. Now the shotgun give to Cook. And he runs this one in for the touchdown. The Bills take the lead right away in half number 2. It's a James Cook touchdown.
Well, this has definitely been a tight one throughout, Brock. So now that they've taken the lead, the question becomes, can they hold on to it?
And that question right there is one the defense has to answer. But this sure had the look of a drive where a coaching staff challenged that offense, saying, hey, we need a big drive from you guys right here. And sure enough, that offense delivers.
Yeah, no doubt.
Basson for the extra point. That one right down the middle. And they'll continue adding to their lead. Bass now to kick this away. Starting from the 5. And in the end, he's able to get it to what used to be a touchback. It's at the 25 after the return. New York taking over once again. The offense heading out. And they're a touchdown back, Brock, as they take over down 21-14.
And the drive will start out with a 1st and 10. Rodgers here from the gun. Got Williams, and it's complete. And he's going to go out of bounds. Looks a little short of the 35.
That is a textbook first down completion. Sets up 2nd and very manageable and creates space to take that shot downfield.
Nice spot here for the offense. It's 2nd and 1. From the 34. No hesitation, and that one's caught. And he'll pick up enough to move the chains.
Look up contested catch in the football dictionary, and you'll see that. I mean, I can't critique the defense there. They're in the hip pocket of that tight end. But these contested catches, these tight ends that can separate with their hands, utilize their body, even when you're covered, you're not.
Has his man, it's Corley.
Every once in a while, it's fine to be conservative on first down, especially when you get enough to stay on schedule and get a little something coming out of it, too.
Second down now, 7 to go. Running this with Hall. He's out in the clear. And they catch up to him, but not until he's got a huge gain and a 1st down. How about 29 yards on that play, partner, as they get the chains reset?
Kate, that's the type of run that shines the light well on him as a runner, of course, but you got to give a lot of credit to everybody else. So, skill guys, when you have an outside run, they got to do their job. Not just the big boys up front, not just the running backs. That takes everyone on the perimeter blocking to get a big run like that.
Going to the ground again on 1st. And he'll only find 1 yard up the gut, 2nd down.
You know, not a ton of yards, but still showing that commitment to the ground game, the type of run that keeps the defense from loading up in coverage and focusing entirely on that passing game.
They'll come to the line here, 2nd and 9. That's complete to Wilson. And he gets back to the line, but no more.
Well, the defense was ready for that throw, stopping him right in his tracks, right at the line of scrimmage.
This drive in jeopardy. Here's a 3rd and 10. Rodgers to throw. He has the 1st over the middle. And they finally bring him down, but that is a big gain and a new set of downs. And even 20 yards on the play, and it awards them with a 1st and goal.
You know, Kate, you'll find teams go to this crossing route concept sometimes a dozen times a game. And a lot of times it's for shorter yardage, but sometimes things break in the right coverage for a much bigger impact play, just like that.
1st down from the red zone. This one's caught. And that play is brought to a halt, they're going to say, at the 5-yard line.
This is one of those kind of win-win situations. Both sides feel good. As an offense, I get a completion. I get a win. As a defense, I keep everything in front of me. I make the tackle for a short gain. I get a win, too. Sometimes you can get to win-win.
One of the tight ends motioning left. Hall running between the tackles. And the defense gets there to force a small loss.
What was supposed to move the chains or at least make 3rd down easier to handle instead? Well, did the exact opposite here, Kate. It now makes this 3rd down a whole lot trickier to figure out.
Buckle up. It's 3rd and goal. Rodgers will look to throw. The Bills getting close, and they take him down. And they're headed in reverse after that sack.
This defense has been trying like mad to do anything to disrupt the rhythm, get the QB off his spot. It's got to be a massive relief to see their efforts paid off on that play.
So the Jets are going to try a field goal on 4th down. Greg Zuerlein headed out. A very short kick here from the right hash. And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. And it's dropped back down now to a four-point game.
That's the type of long, sustained drive that takes some of the starch out of your opponent. The only negative is that the kicking team was out there for a field goal and not an extra point. But they do come away with three.
We've got a good one here. They've cut the lead to four as they send it away. Ty Johnson now to return. He stopped on the return at the 27. Chance here for one final play before the end of the quarter. Cook trying this one up the gut. And they're able to haul him down, and that's going to wrap up this third quarter. Only one quarter remains in our final game of the week. That's the end of the third. It's Bills ball. We'll see if they can hang on to this lead till the end. First down now, ball at the 39-yard line. Play action now, Allen. Catch made right side by Coleman. And he made a bid for midfield there, but stopped on his own side at the 49. Let's see what they want to do here, partner. It's second and inches. Straight ahead, here's Cook. And he'll have it down to the 44-yard line. Call it 7 yards on the play, and that's enough for the first down.
That's certainly a spot where you could be more aggressive, Kate, if you wanted to take your shots. But some coaches, even the bolder ones, will take the safe play first when they get it from time to time. No third down required now.
On the 44-yard line now, first and 10. Operating from the gun, it's Allen. Fires over the middle, caught. And he's able to get this down to the 36. After a good pickup, they're set up with second and short. Sending a receiver left. This is Cook on the handoff. And his short gain gets them a new set of downs.
You know what I like about a second and short run play, Kate? Yeah, I like getting a first down, but you know what I like even more? That's going to set up a play action pass in a similar down and distance, and that defense is going to have to key on the run.
Here's first and 10 from the 34. Working from the gun, it's Allen. Short pass caught by his tight end. And they catch up to him, but not until he's got a huge gain and a first down. They get 22 on that one. And that's good for a Bills first down.
From a great throw to a nice route and catch to moving the chains, there wasn't a whole lot not to like about that amazing play.
All right, set now, first and 10. From the red zone now. This throw is caught. And he drives this forward to the 6. Halfway to the marker, it's second and 5. They'll run it with Cook. And he will score. Touchdown, Buffalo! The Bills now lead by 10. It's a James Cook touchdown. It's what every player who scores a touchdown wants to do, Brock. He wants to get right back there and put another 6 on the board.
I've never met an NFL player content with one end zone trip in a game.
Nope.
Yeah, if you're content, you're not making it to this league. You get one, you're instantly thinking of another, and the fortunate few are able to actually deliver on it.
Basson for the extra point. That one splits the uprights, and they'll continue adding to their lead. Bass now to kick this away. Fielded at the 7. Returns looking good so far. And a good return here as he gets it out past the 35. The Jets are being led back out there on offense by their quarterback. And he has to be happy about his game. We're checking some of the highlights right now that he's made so far. A good showing that's seen him in the zone from time to time. And also, he's just seen the field well from his spot in the middle of this offense. Nice field position for the Jets as they come up 1st and 10. Working out of the gun, it's Rodgers. Corley reels it in. He's still going at the 30. And he breaks into enemy territory before being stopped on a huge gain.
You know, Kate, we often talk about flipping the field in special teams, right? A kick return, a good punt. Well, an explosive play like that does the exact same thing. Look at the difference in field position. By hitting on that shot, you've totally flipped the field and the tone of this drive.
Into the red zone after that big pickup. It's 1st and 10 from the 15. From the shotgun, Rodgers. Able to find Corley. And they bring him down at the 7-yard line.
It takes a certain level of fearlessness, craziness, to work over the middle of the field in this league. You're fighting through guys as you go, and all the while, you know, you could take a lick at any time.
After a good pickup, they're set up with 2nd and short. Shotgun snap, looking to throw. Has it in close. And he's tackled with the 1st down yardage.
It sure seemed like he knew exactly where he was going with that right off the snap.
They'll break the huddle and come up on 1st and goal. Off play action, Rodgers. Ooh, on him quick there, and they bring him to the turf. And the pressure drives them backwards.
1st and goal from the 1. I don't mind throwing it, but that's the one thing you can't have happen. Defensively, you know they're going to bring it. And now, well, they're more than content backing this offense up with the sack.
It's 2nd and goal. Here's Rodgers. He's got it! And he'll go down shy of the end zone. They mark him at the 4.
You know, Kate, over the years, I've heard defensive coordinators say, hey, you got to earn the right to rush your passer. You got to earn the right for me to call blitzes. And when you call a blitz and you don't get home and you don't hit the quarterback, you've earned nothing.
A dose of the hurry-up offense here. Now Rodgers on 3rd and goal. And he will score. Touchdown, New York! The Jets now within 1 score in the 4th. Mike Williams, the touchdown. All right, so the offense does its job, Brock. Now they need their defense to give them a chance to overcome that big deficit.
The momentum in the building's clearly changed. We can feel it here in the booth, but you're right. It's now up to the defense to make a stop and give them a chance.
Huge moment here for the Jets as they go for two. Rodgers trying to throw for it. And he's into the end zone, so the two-point try pays off. They cut the deficit to just a field goal here in the fourth. Critical two-point play there, Brock. The conversion puts them now in range of tying this sucker up with a field goal.
So different for everybody in the building, right? A three-point game, and especially different for the kicker. He wasn't needed there, but get yourself ready. Your defense does the job. You may need a game-tying field goal at some point soon.
Ball is set up and it's away. Just a three-point game now. Here's a return from the seven. Finds some space. He's past the 30. And he manages the 35 before they can stop him. The Bills and quarterback Josh Allen are ready to get back to work now on offense. And he'll be happy to keep letting it fly as much as he has all game. Look at these numbers. They show just how effective he's been in captaining this offense. All right, excellent field position for the Bills as they set up first and 10. This is Cook. And he's only going to get 2 or 3 yards on that one. Second down now, 7 to go. From the shotgun, it's Allen. He's got it at the 30. And he will score. Touchdown, Buffalo. The Bills make it a 9-point advantage. I love plays like this, Brock. Sometimes you just gotta ask your dude, show me what you got, man. Show off those wheels, and he did just that.
Yeah, beauty in simplicity, right?
Yep.
Now, when you run that fly route, you gotta win right from the jump.
Uh-huh.
And you gotta protect yourself from the sideline, too. Don't get pushed to the boundary. Give your quarterback room to throw it up, and you can find pay dirt.
Basson for the extra point. That one right down the middle. And they'll continue adding to their lead. Bass now to kick this away. Fielded at the 7. This return makes it up to the 25. The Jets out to begin another drive. And they're coming off an excellent series throwing the football that led to that touchdown, Brock. So you and I both expecting that defense to be looking for that on this series. Drive starts out with a 1st and 10. Rodgers here from the gun. Quick hitter complete. And that tackle stops him after a solid gain. after a good pickup. They've got second and four. From the 32. To the left sideline, complete. And a solid gain gets them across the 45 before he goes out. This one goes for an even 25 yards. And it's good enough for a New York first down. To throw. Complete out to the right side. And they're going to haul him down a step before the 30, right at the 31. Need to work as quick as you can here, Brock. Two timeouts left, down two scores. It's first down. Throwing now. Tight end reels in the shallow throw. And he'll get it down to the 24-yard line. Jets moving quickly, trying to get the offense set. Now to throw. Wilson's got it.
Kid, I was on the field with a young high school quarterback just last week, and I told him one of the greatest attributes a quarterback can have is courage. And it takes courage to sit in that pocket that long, let a play develop, and let that receiver work all the way from one side of the field to the other, and give him a chance to make a play.
Here he is to throw. That's caught for the first. And he'll pick up enough to move the chains. Timeout taken by New York. That's its second. And they can take a moment to try to build more momentum after getting the first. First and 10, gotta score immediately here. Only one timeout left, and that clock winding down. Looking to throw it. He brings it in. And they're gonna get this down to the 4 before being stopped.
I know that completion doesn't move the chains, but I love it nonetheless. You make sure that defense is aware of every eligible player going out, and this time it was out of the backfield with the running back that shows he's adept at catching it as well.
They'll throw again. Rodgers. The back grabs it. And he hits the end zone. Touchdown. I hope nobody left early, Brock, because we have still got a game. So the offense showing a slightly different dimension there, Brock. Getting the running back involved with his hands for the touchdown.
Yeah, such an advantage. I think when you think about it, Kate, it really is about the 80s where we start to see these running backs not just tote the ball as runners, but be real weapons when they get the ball in the passing game. Yeah. That's well done.
This would put it back within a field goal. That one splits the uprights. And they're a point closer now on the scoreboard. Setting up for a decisive onside kick here, just under 45 seconds left. And the Bills are gonna recover the football, and that should lock up this win. And they'll get him down after he gets into the 48. Buffalo sending its offense to the field. They're headed down now, defending not a two-score lead, just a field goal advantage here. So wondering, Brock, is that going to affect how they approach a chance at closing this one out?
Well, I don't think there's any question about it. Yeah, I think if it's a two-score game, it's run, 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 take every second off and punt that ball. Not now. Now you've got to get to the plays that you trust and believe in the most.
Into the victory formation they go, Brock, here on first down. And they'll kneel this down. Timeout called by the Jets. That's their final one. That's all they had, so the offense free to start running the clock down now. A kneel down here, and they can start to celebrate this win. And they'll take a knee.
Nothing left to do now, Kate, but celebrate on one side and watch on hopelessly from the other. What a hard-fought effort to get to this spot, and now you can enjoy the victory.
After one final kneel down, partner, and this should do it. And he's going to take a knee. So the Bills fight their way to a win on the road. And Brock, we all know any win is a good win, but playing against a division rival, oh, it always feels so much better dealing them one in the L column.
These are the teams that know you best, Kate, but also the ones that you know best. So yes, it is just a little bit sweeter when you take care of business in your own division.
So for Brock Heward, our incredible crew, everybody here at EA Sports, I'm Kate Scott signing off. We'll see you next time.